right, so we got a little hint from Eddie Hearn recently about Anthony Joshua's next opponent now that obviously they're back on top. A lot of people expected before the AJ Ruiz 2 fight that if AJ won, one of the things he might possibly do is either drop the WBO title or the IBF title. He would drop the IBF title particularly because Khubat Pulev is mandatory, and a lot of people did not expect Eddie Hearn's team or Anthony Joshua's team to want that fight just because, you know, not too many people would be interested, especially with the names that are at the top of the division. But Eddie Hearn seems to be saying that it's looking like if Pulev does end up getting past Adam Kawanaki, he would be the first title defense for Anthony Joshua, possibly April of 2020. So what do you guys think about that? So it looks like there's not going to be any type of vacating of any titles when it comes to Joshua's part. I don't know if I agree with it because I feel like Joshua's at the point now where we want to see him against, you know, not necessarily, I don't want to say the best, right? Because Khubat Pulev is one of the best, but we want to see him against the guys that we've been waiting for, the Wilders, the Furies. Like, we want to see those two fights mostly, right? And then also, we want to see the Dillian White rematch, possibly a Joseph Parker rematch, maybe him against Big Baby still, Adam Kawanaki. Like, there's names out there we want to see other than Pulev, but at the same time, I can't be mad at him, you know, fighting is mandatory. Pulev is his mandatory, but I think what would happen if Pulev loses to Kawanaki, things are going to get shooken up a little bit, right? Because he wouldn't be the mandatory anymore, it'll be Kawanaki. And I don't see Anthony Joshua fighting Kawanaki, even though I think he beats him, but we have another Ruiz-Joshua situation where Kawanaki is a PBC fighter, and if he does beat Joshua, the power is back in Al Heyman's hand, and I don't think Eddie Hearn would want to take that chance again. So I see if Pulev somehow loses, maybe the Usyk fight happens earlier than expected because Hearn is saying he wants Usyk after Pulev. So this is all in reference to if these guys win, because I told you there's a mini heavyweight tournament happening in February unless things change. Chisora versus Usyk, that still hasn't been confirmed. People are saying there's a possibility it might be Parker versus Usyk, but whether it's Chisora versus Usyk or Parker versus Usyk, then you got Kawanaki versus Pulev. I feel like all those guys have the opportunity to fight Joshua later in the year, depending on who wins, right? So let me know what y'all think about that. What do you think about Eddie Hearn saying he likes Pulev and Usyk as Anthony Joshua's next opponents next year? Is that something you guys want to hear? Does that disappoint you? And what do you think about the possibility of if Pulev loses to Kawanaki, obviously that goes out the window because I don't see Joshua winning to fight another PBC fighter. So who would you want to see if that happens? And then if Derek Chisora beats Usyk, I don't think Joshua's going to want to fight Chisora. I don't see much coming from that. But if Parker beats Usyk, I see a Parker versus Joshua 2 fight must be happening. But what do you guys think about that? Possible 2020 fights for Joshua? Interested in any of these? Or are you like, man, same old story? Now that he's back in the power, we're going to have this, you know, it's going to be the same old shit for the next 3 years where the people we want to see fight are going to talk about fighting each other, but we know it's not going to happen. Let me know. Like, comment, subscribe, do all the good stuff, and support the music. You already know what it is.